G'day everybody, how are you going today? It is exceptionally good to see you. I do hope you're amazing today. Well, it's a good day. Nikon has released new firmware updates. As they announced a few days ago, they were coming. Here they are, on schedule, on time. That's fantastic. And it is new updates for every single Z camera to date. So that's the Z50, the Z5, the Z6, the Z7, the Z6II, and the Z7II, all receiving little tweaks here and there. So in this video, we're just going to have a quick look at those updates, what they mean, how important they are. Let's talk about what it means to each camera user. Alright, so let's do this in chronological order. We are going to start with the Z6. Now with the Z6, not only do you have a minor bug fix, but we also have something that none of the other cameras out of all of these has, which is the voice memo recording. So you now have the option to record 60 seconds of sound with any given still image, and that can be set up to work by holding down the record button that you use in video mode, whereas in still modes, it will give you a voice memo. This is something I've had for years. I've used it once or twice. I think for some people, it's absolutely invaluable, and it's perhaps something that I could include in my workflow. I'm going to give it a try, but right now it's only on the Z6. They've talked about it coming on the Z6II, and the Z6 also has the save focus point option, along with the Z7. Okay, let's move over to the Z7. And the Z7 has the save focus option as well as one minor bug fix. And that's it. No talk of the voice memo, no talk of any focus improvements. Fabulous. Let's move over to the Z50. It was the next camera to come out. As for the Z50, this update, along with bug fixes, gives us the capacity to save the focus position where it was when you turn the camera off. But that's something that you actually have to turn on if you wanted to do that. And it does need to be noted that the focus point staying in a set position only works with Z autofocus lenses. Of course, there being one Z lens at this point in time, which is not autofocus, and that is the ridiculously expensive Noct. Great. Now let's move over to the Z5. Now, perhaps in this particular round of firmware updates, the Z5 has got the most actual focus improvements. Now, I just have to jump in here and interrupt myself to let you know I was just watching Ricky Talk's video about the firmware updates, and he has actually said that there are improvements, autofocus improvements, to the Z6II and the Z7II. So they have had improvements. Ricky has said this. It's not clear on the actual website, but this is what Ricky has noted. Not only does it have the fact that it will store the previous focus point position, fantastic, but it actually has improvements in focus in low light situations. You do have to have the low light focus function turned on, which is called low light AF, and it can be found in the custom setting A11. So that's an actual focus improvement for the Z5. So Z5 users should be pleased about that. Okay, let's move on to the Z6II. So the version for the Z6II between 1.10 and 1.20 improved live view focus point display response during face eye detection and subject tracking AF. So as I pointed out, it means, I think, that the yellow boxes, both for face and eye, will be more accurately tracking what the camera is actually doing. It has certainly been suggested by some in the past that the Nikons were actually keeping up. The focus was actually in the right spot, but the box wasn't keeping up with what the camera was actually doing, which was giving the user a false sense that things were not as good as they would like. So all in all, this is an improvement for the end user experience, giving them more confidence that what they're seeing is what they are getting. Let's keep reading. Improved the performance of face eye detection AF and subject visibility with optional flash units. Now, that's fantastic. I'm so pleased that's happening when you've got a flash on board. Improved low light autofocus detection times at a focus mode setting of single AF. And this is with single AF mode, so where you are touching and you've got a point somewhere or a box somewhere, and it's fine. You are in essence asking for the focus to happen when you want it. That is the mode that I use most, and so the fact that that might work better in the dark is good for me, but I never really had any major problems with it. So the sort of people who are most worried about face tracking, eye tracking, motion tracking, this particular AF improvement is of least use to them. But still, as I said, any improvement is warmly received.
And this is interesting. Focus accuracy was sometimes unreliable. Well, that statement really could mean anything, and it could change so much.
And then there's a couple of bug fix improvements as well. And finally, let's look at the Z7 II. So the Z7 II has exactly the same updated improvements. So there's nothing much to talk about there. And as I've already said, the only actual focus improvement is when we are in single AF. The other improvements are actually when you add a flash or just how the yellow boxes are responding. Interesting.
And to reiterate, even so it is not on the Nikon website, Ricky has noted that there are general focus improvements for the Z6 II and the Z7 II. And before I go, I do want to add that I feel Ricky stressed very much that there will be further firmware updates to come for the Z6 II and the Z7 II. He stressed we are still in version 1, and for the Z6 and the Z7, we went on to see a firmware version 2 and a version 3. So he is letting us know that he believes there is a lot more updating to come with the Z6 II and the Z7 II.
What we are actually getting, and I can hear it in the comments, most people are not particularly interested in it, but the Z6 is actually getting the voice memo update, which is kind of cool. And the Z6 II is getting it at a later date. Now, I reached out to the community and said, why are we not seeing this on the Z7 and the Z7 II? Why is this happening? And the best answer that the community came back with is perhaps at the last minute when they were beta testing this internally, they couldn't quite iron out some bugs, so they just pull it out. They literally go back to the last version of the code and pull it out, and it'll probably come at a later time. They talked about the ROM in the camera being full or close to full, and there's other features in the Z7 and the Z7 II that might not be in the Z6 and Z6 II. That's another potential reason why it's simply not there. I'm not that much of a software and electronics engineer to know the veracity of those thoughts, but I think they both sound reasonably plausible. And I would have thought the hardware is there on the Z7s. Who knows? Maybe there's some more code optimization, but Nikon, they don't want to talk about something that they don't know whether they can make happen yet. Interesting, isn't it? Because it's not happening on the Z6 II yet, but they've talked about it. They didn't talk about it at all for the 7 and the 7.2. I'd be interested in your thoughts on that. So this is it. It's really a minor selection of updates across all of the Z cameras. Interesting that Nikon have done this all at once. Does this signify that we're bringing all of this to a full stop so they now can start talking about what's next? I've got a video coming up next, which is talking about when do I think Nikon are actually going to start making some announcements around lenses and so on and so forth. Fantastic to see you. Oh, and I'd love to see you again. So please do subscribe. Please share. Please click on the bell to make sure you're notified. Please like. And if you'd like to watch over 300 episodes right now, you can just look down there and come and visit us at our Block Place Gallery. We've got bricks and mortar, we've got real pictures, real books, real people. Come on down, say hi, support the channel. Amazing. All right. I'll see you in the next one.
And in these situations where everything is dynamic, you just gotta go. You gotta go when it's happening. I don't know how I got to ISO L. As I said in the previous video, this sort of thing, because of the rotation of the Earth and the tilt of the Earth, will only have direct sunlight like this for perhaps 2 weeks.